Hello and welcome back to UCCX Administration and Scripting course series. My name is Anas. I'm a senior collaboration engineer with CCI certification. In the last videos, we have explained how UCCX handles time of day, day of week, and holidays that fall on a particular date, as well as we have covered the holidays that follows perpetual calendar. In today's video, we are going to cover switch step in UCCX scripting, which is an efficient alternative to using many if statement. To give you better understanding, I'll open up one of the previous script that we have used to handle holidays. This is the script that we have used to handle holidays. If you pay attention to the highlighted if statement, we are defining a date string variable and we are assigning the current date to it. After assigning that, in the if statement, what we are doing is we are checking whether this date string variable is equal to either the holiday 1 or the holiday 2. If the statement is true, then the UCCX will be playing a prompt to the user, a general prompt to the user informing that the business is closed for holidays. And then it will be going to the label 1, which is at the end of the script or the bottom of the script where it will be playing a by prompt. However, imagine a requirement where you want to play specific prompt to the user for each and every holiday. For example, if the user is calling you on holiday, then you want to play a prompt specifically recorded for Christmas Day. And similarly, if the user is calling you on Independence Day, then you want to play a specific prompt that is recorded for the Independence Day. If you want to achieve this kind of requirement, one way of doing is using multiple if statement. For example, I'll take you to the slide. Let's take a look at here in the if statement. In order to play specific prompt for each and every holiday, what you'll have to do is you'll have to assign the current date to the day variable. And then using the if statement, you'll have to check whether this value in this day variable is equal to the holiday that you wish to play the prompt to the user. In this example, the December 25, Christmas Day. If the current date is equal to 25, December 23, then the user will be hearing a prompt specifically recorded for Christmas. Else it will be going to the next step. And again, it will be checking if the day is equal to 23/11/23, which is for Thanksgiving. And if the statement is true, then it will be playing the prompt for Thanksgiving, similarly for the Labor Day as well. So each and every time when you want to check the current date is equal to the list of holiday that you have in your company, you'll have to use an if statement. So we have an efficient method to overcome using multiple if statement that is called switch step. So let's take a look at how the switch step handles the same scenario. So we are setting the day is equal to current date, and in switch statement we are calling that particular day variable, and then there are several cases that we can define for each and every holiday. In this example, for case 1 we are defining Christmas, and for case 2 we are defining Thanksgiving, and for case 3 we are defining Labor Day. If the statement in the switch matches any of the case mentioned below, then it will be playing the prompt or taking the action which is defined under that particular case. Now let's implement the same in the script. For that, what we will do is we will simply delete this if statement and we will substitute this if statement by the switch step. We'll go to General tab, we'll select the switch step and we'll place it on top of date string and we'll expand it. We have a default condition or default case. We'll click on switch properties, and here what we will select is date string, and we will add the cases. Since the date string is a string variable, what we will do is we will put that into double quotes. Let's give the Christmas date 25/23. Connection, we will give the name Christmas. Click OK. We will add one more connection. We will add today's date, that is 7/10/23. we will name it as training day. Click OK. We'll have to put that in double quotes. Click OK. We will add one more case. We will give it as New Year Day. New Year. Click OK. Now we will apply. OK. Now we have all the switch cases populated here, including default. Now let's add the prompt variable for Christmas and training day. First, we will upload the prompt to the UCCX. Open up UCCX. Login, prompt management, EN, UCCX training, upload prompts, browse, documents, UCCX prompts, then Christmas holiday, open, upload, browse, training day, open, upload. Now we have uploaded both the prompts. Return to script management. Now we have Christmas holiday and training day prompts uploaded here. Click on new variable. Type prompt name Christmas and value. We'll copy the path and paste it here. And click OK. Now we'll again add one more. Type prompt name training day and value. We will copy the path of the training day wav file. Copy and paste. Click OK. Now let's go to the media directory. We'll select the prompt variable and place it on top of Christmas. And then we will select another prompt variable and we'll put it on top of training day. For Christmas, we'll click on properties, prompt, select Christmas, apply, OK. And for training day, click on properties, prompt, training day, apply. Okay, now for New Year, we don't have a recording for New Year. For what we will do is I'll simply put a label there. And I will click on properties and I'll change it as, just for understanding, play prompt New Year for New Year Day. You don't have the recording. Apply. Okay. For default statement, we are not doing anything. It'll automatically will be going to the day of week condition. We have completed the scripting successfully. Now we have to test it. First of all, we will validate it. Validation is successful. Now go to file, save as. We'll name it as switch step. Save. Now we will upload the script to UCCX. Go to applications. Script management, upload scripts, browse, UCCX scripts, switch step, upload, return to script management, applications, applications management, CSA. We will select switch step, update, okay. Now we will give a test call here.
Business is closed for training day.
Hello and thank you for
calling. Now the script is working. What we will do is we will give a reactive debug as well to give clear understanding of the step that it is taking. So we will click on debug, reactive script. We'll select the script name, switch step. And we'll give 120, click on OK, and we'll give another test call. Now it is on the start step. It is on top of the accept step. Now the call is accepted. Now it is on top of date string variable. The moment I move from date string variable, here the date string variable will be populated with the current date. So now it moved to switch string and the date string variable is populated with the current date. And one of the cases that we defined in the switch step is training day, which is matching for today's date. So if we click on next step, it will be the control will be moving to the training day. Now it will be playing the prompt for training day.
Business is closed for training day.
So our reactive scripting also shows that our script is working. Now we have successfully implemented a switch case in UCCX scripting for handling holidays like Christmas, training day, and New Year. So that's all for today's video. I hope you enjoy the video. I'll be uploading more videos like this in coming days. So hit the like button and subscribe to the channel to get updates on our posts. Thank you for watching and have a nice day ahead. Bye-bye.